Video for a while now using a remote timer for my Canon 60D, and I thought this is the perfect time to do it. And so here I am, and it is almost dark, so here we go. So my setup is basically I have a Canon 60D here, and I've plugged in my remote just on the side here, and I'll show you the type of model that I have for my remote. This one's a cheap one from eBay, but it does the job pretty well. So if you just type that into eBay or on Google and see if you can hunt down something similar to this or newer, I'm pretty sure the functionality would be very, very close. So the first thing you need to do with your camera is to set it to bulb mode. Otherwise the remote won't work. So once you've set it to bulb mode and you've plugged it in, you set up your let me just turn it back on. So you set up your aperture and all that sort of thing. So there's my settings here. So don't worry about how long your shutter speed is, because the actual remote will take control of that. So my ISO, yeah, is set at 100, and my f-stop is at 8, or if you want to call it, your aperture is set at 8. So on the remote here, now this one's running out of batteries, but to go through it very, very simply is to, I'll go to the start, so I'll just press the mode button. I go to this one here, and the way you set the settings here is you press your mode, of course, to go to the different modes up the top. But on the side of the remote here, there is like a little wheel that you scroll up and down, and you can actually press it in to change the values. So this one here is the timer. I go to mode. This is my interval. So the interval is how many seconds between shots it takes. So it will wait 8 seconds before a new photo is taken. The long means how long the shutter speed is open for. So mine's only going to be open for 2 seconds. And the frames is set to, generally I set this to 0, which means that it will keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going. If you wanted a certain number of frames, for example, if you only wanted 50 shots, then you set that value to 50, and then after 50 photos it stops. So I just want it to keep going forever, it doesn't matter. So let's go back to mode. So this is the timer. So in let me just press it for you. So if I just start here, so you can see the numbers. So there's 5 seconds for self. Oops. The interval is for 8 seconds. There is 2 seconds for how long it's for, and there are 0 frames. So if you watch the numbers closely, you'll be able to figure out pretty quickly what how many seconds are for what. So I'm gonna hit start. So it's gonna count down from 5 seconds till it takes its first photo. 2 seconds is over. Now it's counting down from 8 seconds till it takes its next photo. And if you hear the clicking in the background, that's what it is. So here we go. It's just going to keep going and going and going. So I'm just going to stop that. If I go back to the beginning where it says self, that 5 seconds means it's going to count down initially from the very start for 5 seconds, and then after that, it's every 8 seconds it will take a photo. So this is great for time-lapse photography. If you wanted a photo, say you wanted let's just change the mode here. So you wanted between photos for the interval, you want to say 10 seconds between each photo. And for each, however long you want your shutter open, you want it set for 2 seconds. And then your frames, you might say I only want, 100 frames to be taken in that time. Again, if you set it to zero, it's infinity. And that's pretty much it. That's the whole remote. It is simple as, and this is probably the easiest one I've got actually. I have bought another one from eBay, but it's not as good as this one. And it does have a light on there, a light functionality for nighttime, so it is pretty cool. Sometimes it does have a mind of its own though, because I think the battery is going low, so it changes a few settings. But other than that, if you don't want to use it for example, a open shutter, so you can set it so that the shutter opens and stays open for, it could be half an hour if you wanted to. So it's great for doing those nighttime shots where you want star trails, where it sort of bleeds, or not bleeds, but you can see the streaks in the stars. And if I change it back to, say, manual mode, then I can use this just as a remote. So I can just, instead of me pressing the button to take a photo, I can just do it obviously via a remote. So there's no camera shake at all when I take photos. So